मॉड्यूल 8 स्केच कंपोजिशन फॉर इंडोर म्यूरल। एमिनेंट क्यूबिस्ट आर्टिस्ट एंड पेंटर जॉर्जेस बराक हैज राइटली सेड, द स्टार्टिंग पॉइंट ऑफ अ पिक्चर फॉर एनी पेंटर इज अ मैटर ऑफ कलर्स एंड फॉर्म्स। आई बिलीव दैट द पोइट्री ऑफ आर्ट, इफ दैट इज व्हाट वन मे कॉल इट, इज अ मैटर ऑफ एनिमेटिंग दीज फॉर्म्स एंड कलर्स। After fixing the drawing sheet on the drawing board, I draw a rough small sketch on A4 size bond paper in felt pen or marker pen. I keep it on my left hand side on the drawing sheet and start the larger version of this mural design after drawing a rectangle and a circle as visible in a small sketch. I draw two curvy lines underneath the circle, then by using the scale or ruler, I draw horizontal lines downward. I again draw two crooked curvy lines, which overlap the horizontal lines. Now I start darkening the line around the lower portion of the circle, which looks like the neckline of the garment. According to American poet and philosopher Henry David Thoreau, this world is but a canvas to our imagination. Repeating this process, I darken the first crooked line with crisscross strokes, thereby darkening the area around this line. Now I erase a few unwanted lines outside the mural design to keep the sheet clean and remove the residue with the help of a duster. After pondering from a while, I again think of darkening the line below the circle. And now it is the turn to darken the second crooked line below the first one to ascertain the shape of the form. I use the similar technique of quick strokes criss-crossing and darkening the outer area of the line, and these two wave-like forms are generated in the mural design. I now start darkening the horizontal lines so that a band type form comes out. The same exercise is repeated for the lower horizontal line, which I leave it nearly midway and turn to darkening the area with the pencil shade around third wave like curvy line. Here a triangle like form is generated on the right and left hand side under the curvy line. Thank you. I keep on adding pencil strokes on the second bend on the sides, and another triangle-like shape emerges on left and right hand side. I calculate the design formation in my hand, and after waiting for a while, start darkening the left hand side portion of the third bend. In the circle, I make the sketch of Bodhisattva Padmapani figure after taking reference from the mobile image, and fill different tones of brown and green in this area to bring out the shape of the figure so that the Bodhisattva comes out from the lighter background. I fill the first curvy crock shape with yellow ochre watercolor using a round brush, and the next form is filled with bluish green watercolor. The next shape is filled with light brown color in quick brush strokes. Now I fill the two triangular shapes which I had darkened earlier in pencil strokes. I apply lighter tone of pale color in the first horizontal band and leaving the middle band blank. Thereby I fill the third blank band with pale color, leaving a triangle-like shape untouched at the right-hand side of the band. Now I move to last horizontal band and fill it with pale tone. I fill the second and fourth horizontal bands with light brown color, leaving circular blank space under the second and fourth bands. I apply darker tone to bring out the last curvy line which passes through the horizontal bands and create a necklace like shape touching the triangle like shapes again with darker tone. I again darken the second last band with black color and use a thinner round brush to darken the areas at the bottom. I use the same method to accentuate the lines below the circle and draw a vertical finishing line. Now I try to show the broken area by touching the cropped line near the last three horizontal bands. To define the different lines and shapes, I used to pencil to draw the outline of these forms and add some rectangular shapes and lines to generate interest in the blank bands so that the composition looks interesting with different textures. The same method is applied here and there below the necklace-like curvy lines. Small rectangles are used to provide the composition with another dimension to generate visual impact and provide a mosaic-like effect. The outlines of curvy shapes are being darkened so that they emerge from the lower surface and provide a movement to the composition. I apply finishing touches to the composition and define the lines of the rectangular shape of the mural design. To add more compositional elements, I keep on touching and creating small forms by darkening the areas to break the monotony in the composition. Some areas are darkened to submerge them, and the main circular wavy necklace-like forms emerge prominently. I keep on defining the shapes or the elements by darkening the areas with quick and calculated pencil strokes. Some more small rectangles are added in pale toned blank horizontal bands. In the first curvy form, I create a texture with crisscross pencil strokes, and small broken shapes are generated with look like mosaic pattern. In the similar fashion, I give finishing touches to the figure in the circle. An artist has to ponder and evaluate the composition time and again and add suitable strokes so that forms are defined and blank space are handled with textural mosaic-like shapes. This gives the mural an antique look. One has to keep on adding visual impact on the composition of the mural by adding quick irregular textures on the blank spaces. It is up to the creative ingenuity of the artist to add suitable spaces, which sometimes add to the visual charm and provide ornamental dimension. These irregular lines give the impression of broken tiles, and overall cohesive and finished look is achieved as most of the murals in the final stages are created with colored ceramic tiles with irregular shape and sizes. These lines also give the look of cracks. After all these engaging and engrossing effort, the final mural composition gives an interesting and appealing effect and can suitably be enlarged and executed on a wall as per the requirement of the artist or his client.